Hey, all Caps fans, welcome to another episode of the Weekly Spotlight. This week, we're going to spotlight Verdun Sport and Fashion, Verdun Footwear. I'm here with the business owner, Clayton Murray. Clayton, thanks for joining me.
You bet, not a problem.
So, Clayton, you purchased Verdun Footwear. Let's talk about that first. In 2014, when you purchased a store, what was your goals that you wanted to accomplish in doing that?
You know what? We were moving back to Verdun. We looked at a number of different businesses, and the shoe store seemed to be a good fit for us. It was a family-run business, and we were sort of able to slide in with our family and just start going. We'd owned a small business in Winnipeg as well, and knew we wanted to stay in business for ourselves, and it seemed to be a good fit.
So Verdun, obviously, is a tight-knit community. What makes being a local business owner so special?
You know what? Everybody supports everybody. Everybody wants to deal with local business, and you have to be willing to be the face of the business in a small town, and we embrace that fully. That people will ask to deal with Clayton Murray or Bonnie Murray, or before they'll say the name of the business, and those are definitely good perks to have.
So with Verdun Footwear, do you get lots of customers that come from the city, like Brandon or even Winnipeg?
For sure, yeah. We get piles from Brandon, honestly, that come out. That there's not a lot of independent shoe stores or other stores left in the world, and we're glad that we have some of them, and which gives a lot more brand power, a lot more, we can find something unique. If you want a generic shoe, you can go anywhere, but we definitely have more unique stuff.
So obviously, like, finding the proper shoe is pretty important. You know, myself, I have to wear orthotics. Like, do you guys specify that kind of stuff too?
You bet. Yeah, we do lots of work with orthotics. We actually work with a few of the foot doctors as well out of Brandon.
Okay.
And we supply them with shoes and their clients with shoes as well. That's a huge part of what we do.
So let's shift over to 2016. You had Verdun Sport and Fashion. When you purchased that part, what did you hope to accomplish with that?
With that part, we just wanted, obviously we're a huge sports family. We love sports, and yeah. The store had always intrigued us. We'd sort of went to the prior owner about a year before that, after we'd been here about a year again, and said, do you have any interest in selling? And of course, at that time they didn't. And one day my phone rang and she said, yeah, I think I'm ready. I think I'm done with retail. So it took a while. We worked out the deal, and the stores complement each other. A lot of the brands cross over from footwear to clothing. And the sporting goods side of it is just something we thoroughly enjoy. Our kids enjoy it. So they sort of go together.
What kind of sports stuff do you sell there?
We have a little bit of everything, honestly. A little bit of hockey, a little bit of curling, a little bit of golf, baseball, pickleball now, badminton, tennis, a little bit of everything.
So when you get you sell clothing too, do you have any new clothing lines you want to talk about?
Yeah, I mean, our biggest clothing lines are your Under Armours, but we have a lot of unique, more boutique style stuff as well, that a lot more ladies clothing than people actually know we have. That everybody assumes all the time that we're strictly a sports store with sports clothing, and we actually have a lot of ladies clothing as well.
So with the pandemic, obviously, how grateful are you that you've been able to keep your doors open?
It's crazy. The shoe store we've been able to keep open with limited access. We are winter boots, work boots, that kind of thing are essentials.
Yeah.
The clothing sports store has been closed to the public. We've been doing curbside and online deliveries, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. It's definitely made us rethink how you do business, and especially in a small town.
That was going to be my next question. Like, how have you been able to navigate through COVID, and what are your biggest challenges as a local business?
I think our biggest challenges have been that we've spent, well, just about 7 years now preaching shop local, come for the shopping experience. You don't need to shop online. Yeah. And then we've had to totally switch gears this year, promoting our online shopping, which has sort of been everything we stand against. But honestly, our customers have been very good and very loyal. We can't say enough about them. They've kept us afloat during these last 8 months for sure.
So if there's a person new to the area, like, what would you say to promote your business?
I would say that, honestly, we could help you. If you combine both our businesses, we could outfit every member of your family, from work to play to sports to whatever the need is. We have it all covered.
You've been a supporter of the Verdun All Capitals. We appreciate that. Why is it so important for local businesses to support the All Capitals?
You know what? Again, we're a sports family. We love sports. But on a business level as well, it brings people to town. We have met so many families, so many players' families. That have come to town and have loved Verdun, and the kids have loved Verdun, and they love shopping in our small towns. They love eating in our small towns. And I think that's what's so important to anything, not just hockey, but any event you can bring to a small town, it benefits every single one of us.
So before we record, you mentioned you're born and raised, you're born in Winnipeg, right?
No, actually I was born in Verdun and we moved to Winnipeg for 17 years. Gotcha. And then had kids and decided we wanted to move back to Verdun, and here we are.
So you're involved, I see, with the U19 hockey team. What made you get into coaching?
I've always coached since my guy's been little. This year I decided it was time to step up and head coach, I guess. That I firmly believe they need to have different coaches each year, and I've helped on the assistant side and thought this was the year to step up and be a head coach.
So
and now we're not playing, I guess.
Yeah, true. Hopefully we get back soon.
I hope so too.
Going into the new year, what are you hoping changes with the COVID front?
I hope that, and I firmly believe that when this new one expires on January 8th, they will allow access now because the crowds will be gone, and I think they will have accomplished what they wanted to. I hope they open up stores with limitations, of course. This is not going away anytime soon.
Yeah.
But I think there is a solution there for our stores to be open with limited access and proper cleaning and so on. So I hope that's the case for the new year.
Christmas is right around the corner. Do you have any family rituals that you like to do or traditions?
We do. We usually get together with all of our families, and we're, again, big on skating, big on tobogganing, but it's going to be a little bit smaller this year with just our immediate family. But I think as soon as Christmas is over, we're going to take off to the cottage and do some snowmobiling and tobogganing and have a great time.
Awesome. Clayton, thanks for joining me. We appreciate all your support that you've had for us these past few years, and best of luck with your companies in the new year.
Perfect. I appreciate it, Blake. Thanks a lot. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you too.
Take care.